A nice morning, full moon, a little rain out there.
Yeah, a little rain. That's nothing to worry about, right, Jason?
Yeah, guys, you know, just these passing downpours, and we could have some wet roadways. Of course, Kimberly will be along to tell us more about what's going on with the traffic. But right now, outside, taking a look downtown, a few drops on the lens there from our downtown cam. We'll be in the upper 80s later this afternoon. Fairly comfortable start to the day. But that one shower that was going on through downtown has moved on. Let's take a look at Viper Plus. I'll show you what's going on out there across the rest of the area. Up around Marineland, we've had some rainfall. Let's get you up there. That one is beginning to dissipate as well, so that's just fine. We take a look down into Orange County, right around Seminole as well. Just maybe a few sprinkles left over, but really most of this is going to be off into Brevard County now. You can see some pretty heavy rainfall coming in along the Cape, Cape Canaveral, right around Cocoa and Rockledge. Also some heavier rains moving over toward Holapaw there, out of Satellite Beach. So we're tracking all that for you as it moves over to the west, and we'll be watching that off and on, I think, throughout the day today. Temperatures right now about 73 degrees across the inland areas over toward the beaches, 79 at Cocoa Beach, 75 at Daytona Beach right now. We'll be in the mid to upper 80s for the afternoon. Palm Coast, 85. Daytona Beach, 86. Titusville, 87, as well as Melbourne, 88, 89 from Orlando back toward Claremont. Maybe a 90 squeaking out here and there. So very close to average. Sun up about 7:15 or so. As we take a look at the maps, we have high pressure still offshore feeding us that onshore flow. We also have this area of low pressure in the upper levels off our southwest coast. And at the surface, now we have an area of low pressure trying to develop. So the question is, where does this low go and how quickly does it develop? I think over the course of tonight and tomorrow, we should start to see a low-level circulation take shape. Now, the models kind of want to bring this thing offshore from us, and we could see some tropical development out of this, but it's going to be off of our coastline and putting us on the drier side of things. So if this low moves a little further closer to land, we could see some rainfall tomorrow enhanced, but I think it's going to stay east of us, and that's going to put us on the dry side. We'll keep an eye on the track, but it does look like rain coverage not a whole lot more than about 40% over the next couple of days with this feature. Now, as we take a look elsewhere, we've got plenty of things going on. Karen out here, another tropical wave behind that, a wave in the Antilles. And there's this area of low pressure I'm watching there near us. And then, of course, Tropical Depression 13 back in the Gulf. That one could become Lorenzo. So let's start you out over here with Karen and also this other wave. Both of these are going to be heading northwestward. Right now, Karen's still a tropical storm with 50-mile-an-hour winds, but it's forecast to become a hurricane as early as Friday morning and still stay out over the open waters of the Atlantic. So that's good news there. Tropical Depression 13, 30-mile-an-hour winds now. You can see those thunderstorms blowing up here the last few frames. It is expected to encounter some lighter wind shear, head off to the west as a tropical storm. That would be Lorenzo somewhere into Mexico coming up by the end of the week. And then into the Antilles, you can see thunderstorms blowing up there near Puerto Rico associated with this wave as it's moving northwestward. That one slowly could develop, but it's going to be a while. We'll keep an eye for sure. Here's your 5-day plus two, though. 88 today, 90 tomorrow, 91 on Friday. A weak front slides in here and kicks up the winds for the weekend, and we're going to keep that rain coverage right about 40% over the next couple of days.